Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle. The Economic Community of West African State Parliamentarians has harped on the need to make concerted efforts to ensure proper implementation of policy framework on women empowerment and discrimination in the sub-region. Speaker of the ECOWAS Parliament, Sidi Tounis, made the call at the opening of the delocalized meeting of the Joint Committee on Social Affairs, Gender and Women Empowerment, Education, Science and Culture in Monrovia, the Liberia capital. He said, as parliamentarians, it is their duty to promote and protect legal policies to combat all forms of violence and discrimination against women, thus urging those in authority to adhere to the Beijing Declaration in order to achieve the 30% representation of women in policy making for sub-regional economic growth.
It is our responsibility as legislators and politicians to promote and protect legal and policy frameworks that not only prevent and combat all forms of discrimination against women, but also promote their empowerment. Talk to achieve concrete progress in improving the status of women, including improving their economic opportunities, recognizing and strengthening women's legal status and rights, and facilitating women's participation and inclusion in decision-making and political processes. We must endeavor to carry them along in every aspect of our undertakings. We should see them as the ones who complement us, not compete with us. We must see them as our right-hand persons, not rivals. We must see them as collaborators and not contenders. In this regard, we have an important role to play as parliamentarians.
Also speaking on the theme of the conference, the Liberian President George Weah urged the members of the parliament to galvanize efforts to come up with a workable solution that will advance the cause of empowering women and girls in the sub-region.
The theme, the empowerment of women in the ECOWAS region. This is a matter that is very close to my heart. As Liberian feminist in chief, I'm deeply dedicated and committed to the ideas of the empowerment of women in all aspects of our society, but particularly in leadership. I pray that the resolutions you will adopt here during this joint committee sitting will go a long way to advance the cause of women's empowerment in our region.
Earlier, the wife of the Liberian president, Claire Weah, in her opening remarks, called for actionable solution to end all forms of violence against women and ensure women empowerment across all sectors. She noted that despite improved awareness of women's worth in society, violence against women is of the increase, hence much is needed to enhance women's protection and inclusion across the ECOWAS region, thus clamoring for collective effort to find a lasting solution to issues that affect all women, and not just in politics or business, but all women in the region.
We're here to talk about serious steps to ensure that every woman and every female in our region has access to all she needs to ensure that she fulfills her potential and contributes to the development of our society. The theme of empowerment of women in ECOWAS region speaks of coming together to agree on a common approach for ensuring that no girl or woman in our region feels abandoned or deprived of any opportunity by virtue of her gender. There are also many issues which seriously require our attention and to which our focus must be clear, determined, and dedicated, and to which we must collectively begin to find long-lasting and meaningful solutions.
Meanwhile, the Liberian Minister for Gender, Children and Social Affairs, William Atatar, lamenting on the adverse effect of the COVID-19 pandemic, noted that the scope of inequality has continued to widen, especially on members of the social groups and displaced persons, stressed the need for a collective approach to cope with the menace.
COVID-19 global pandemic amplified and heightened all existing inequalities, including sexual and gender-based violence. As the COVID-19 outbreak continues to affect all segments of the population, there is the existential threat of these inequalities intensifying, which will be particularly detrimental to members of social groups in the most vulnerable situations, including people living in poverty, rural women and girls, older persons, persons with disabilities, indigenous people, migrants, refugees, and displaced persons.
These parliamentarians are optimistic that addressing violence and inequality against women and girls can only be achieved should authorities and head of state put into practice all the existing policy framework regarding women empowerment in the ECOWAS sub-region. Vincent Okushi, reporting for Quality Television. Audio Jungle.